So now let's look at the data. If the data forces you to clean it up, which is a waste of time, inefficiency, before you can analyze it, we call it bad data. If data can be got in such a way that people can actually work on it without any analysis or without any cleanup. Just let me go back one slide. There was a problem. So if you get data, you waste time in cleaning it up, we call it bad data. But if you get data which is well behaved and doesn't require you to clean up, we call it good data. Now, conceptually, this looks nice, but it's important to tell you what exactly good data means. There has to be some method by which you look at it and realize, is it good or bad? How do we do that? So it's a very simple definition. Data, if it's like a table, it's called good data, tabular data. So simple example. Everything should have a heading followed by data. The data should be consistent in each column. Now, this sounds simple, but very often this itself can get spoiled. For example, in this case, where we have exactly same headings, but the data type got mixed up. Or in this case, even worse, we have put two kinds of information in one column. This is another common problem, which if you don't notice and correct at an early stage, you will waste a lot of time analyzing that data. Another example I recently found, this is from a government site, data.gov.in, which gives you government related data. It's a simple tabular data. Most of it is common, most of it is good, but there is a hash sign there, and that hash indicates it is provisional. Now, if you want to indicate something is provisional, do not put that as a part of the base cell itself. If you want to put it as provisional, put an extra column called status and then put provisional yes or no. That is what I mean by making data good. So here are very simple rules for checking whether the data you have received is good or bad. Some of you may be technical people. In technical terms, it is called normalization, but I don't want to confuse users with unwanted jargon. So when you get the data, concept is simple. Look at it, apply all these principles. If any of them is missing or wrong, that means the data is bad. And then what do you do next? Now, the most important thing you don't do is continue working on analyzing the data in spite of knowing that it is in bad format. And that is what we have been doing for years, which exponentially increases the time required for cleanup and analysis. Now, what do you do in that case? You get the data, you check it. If it is good, continue. If it is bad, don't even attempt to convert it to good or clean it up. Send it back to the source, because typically data has come from somewhere. Either someone did data entry, someone you purchased it from somewhere, it came from some system report, someone gave you a CSV file. That entity or person is called the source. Just send it back to them and say, I want it in this format where it is tabular. And believe me, very often, especially from an IT system or business system point of view, all the data in the world is stored in tabular format in most cases. So for them to give it to you in tabular form is easier than giving it to you in a spoiled format. So just attempt it. If it works, well and good. If it doesn't, then of course you need to know how to convert data to good format.